Imtiyaz, just a word on Sun TV today. We spoke about that with Siddharth. What's your view as far as Sun TV is concerned? What are charts telling?
Pankaj, no doubt we have seen a very fantastic rally. I think so from last 7-8 trading session, we had been looking the stocks Sunday, we are on a higher top, higher bottom formation. But no doubt it has come back to the near the resistance somewhere around 440 level. So until unless this stocks does not surpass the area of 440 level, I don't think so there would be any further room, because stock has gone in on the overbought situation on daily chart. So there might be the chances where we can see the stock showing some sort of a retracement, maybe around 40-50% of the rally. So this that level would be the very good for the stocks to accumulate. But as of now, since the stock is in an overbought situation, I would definitely say to be on a cautious note, only above 440 we can see this fresh room going upside.
Right, but as of now there is no hurry to buy.
I would definitely wait for the stocks to show some sort of a retracement.
Right. How would you look at Motherson Sumi 290 off the day's high, but still 8% higher?
Pankaj, today the stock has given a breakout of multiple tops. There was a multiple tops in the month of April and in the month of March. So today we have seen some sort of a breakout. I believe that the stock sustain about 280 level and give a close about 280 level. So that would be the very good for the Motherson Sumi to have this double top formation breakout. So once this breakout happened today about 280 level, so the next target would be somewhere around 310, 320 would be the figure. But that will definitely going to take time, because the time horizon which has been taken to call off this entire double top formation was almost near about 20 to 22 trading sessions. So we have to wait, but the result would be very good in terms of on the higher side. The target would be 310, 320.
Right. Siddharth, any view on Motherson Sumi? Did you look at the numbers?
No, I have not seen the numbers in detail, but overall what we have seen, what the management was talking about, was the kind of OEM growth has been got from Maruti, especially Nissan also. I think company, because company completely supplies to these companies, so with that the kind of OEM growth and the passenger vehicle growth is seen, company is doing good on terms of supplies are concerned. Margins are expected to improve going forward, although we don't cover the stock very closely, but what we believe is in the OE, in the auto ancillary space, this company is really placed well. So historical, there are some kind of one-offs with the company, the kind of stories which we have seen regarding Volkswagen, but I think overall on the auto ancillary space, what we like is Gabriel, and Gabriel India is one of the company which we really like apart from any other company.
Right. You know, I just wanted to highlight that Voltas, I think, has just declared numbers, and the numbers on the face of it are looking in good. So we'll just pull up the name Voltas. I think it's immediately seen a very, very big spike. It's up almost about 2.5 to 3 odd percent. So we'll just try and pull the numbers out. But, you know, on the face of it, it's looking that the numbers are pretty good. So the sales numbers have come in at 1888, which is versus a pole of around 1600. Net profit at about 176, and the expectation was close to 120 odd crores. Numbers coming in at the bottom of your screen as well. If there is no one-off into this number, I think this will be taken very, very positively by the market. Siddharth, Voltas, we just spoke about it. You think if operationally it's a beat and a big beat, there is still room to see a lot of re-rating, as in the trust would increase?
Yes, of course, and the kind of severe summer what we have seen, in anticipation of that, there is quite a good AC sales. So the consumer part of the business was really doing good, and in fact this quarter also they would be posting good set of numbers, although they would be priced in, but they're kind of a little bit of a more growth in terms of volume growth is concerned. With that, the engineering part of the business, I think one has to look at the numbers in details, that how is that panned out, and is there any one-offs in the results? Yes.
So, you know, the engineering business, or as they call the electromechanical projects, has done an EBIT of around 13 crores. It was expected to do a loss of around 4 to 5 crores. You think a very big positive or just a positive?
It's a very big positive, because the engineering business turning around and coming from on the EBIT side, it coming to profits from loss, I think that is really positive. And how are their projects and how are their executions are happening? If the details of this, if management comes out with their view, I think that would really help out to gauge that what are the next quarter results. Because from the consumer side, as I have said earlier also, this quarter results also would be quite interesting from the consumption side.
Right. And, as you just said about the earlier quarter, you think that the important thing would also be what is the sort of guidance they give, especially for Q1, because that should be like more than 50% of their entire year's sales, at least for the AC division, which the street seems to be excited about.
Absolutely. And I would say if management is giving some kind of a guidance, I think there is quite a good hope from the analyst community of beating that guidance, because there has been stellar set of volume growth seen in other companies in terms of volumes are concerned. Because if we talk about the channel checks from the consumer showrooms and all that, I think there is a great pickup in volume growth seen.
Right. You know, the exceptional gain is about 28 crores. But despite that, I was just calculating the EBITDA for Voltas. So I'll just put across the numbers. It's about 184 crores. And I was expecting around 143 crores. So do you think still one should look at the operational numbers despite there being a one-off?
Yeah, despite being a one-off, then also I think numbers looks quite good. With that, one has to see what kind of a volume growth in the consumer side they have got. With that, is there any kind of a margin expansion? Because there is possibility of margin expansion also. And from at the top line, also there is a growth coming, and engineering division turning around from loss to profit. I think this is something good, green shoot seen in Voltas. And I think if the management guidance is from the engineering side is also good, I think there would be quite a good rally in this in next 3 to 6 months.
Right. Imtiyaz, any view on the technical side on Voltas? 340, a new level today?
Yes, Pankaj, what we had seen on the weekly chart or maybe on the chart, the stocks were showing some sort of a weakness from the level of 360. The stock has fallen down and somewhere around the stock has made a bottom in the month of February 2016, around 211. And in that structure, the stock was supposed to go somewhere near 350, 360 level. So the stock is coming back to achieve its target around 360 or maybe little bit enlarge about 360, maybe around 380 or 390. That would be the level to watch out. I think so this momentum would definitely continue and would attract some more buying at this current level.
Imtiyaz, what's your view as far as Adani Ports is concerned, 182?
Pankaj, after the result, we have seen a big damages coming for the Adani Port, and I think so this damage is going to continue. But one thing is very much important to understand that on a daily chart, the stock has gone into the oversold zone. And from last time where the stock has been rallied, the level was around 170 level. So I think so the support would definitely come, because if I see the in terms of retracement, that already the stock has rallied and retraced almost 88% of the rally. Very good sign. I think so one should wait for the stocks to give a higher close. The moment when the higher close come, I think so the stocks can tend to see some sort of a retracement of the fall. Maybe the stocks can go back to around 200 level or 210 level. So wait for the stocks to give a higher closing, and from that level I think so one can see 100 and 210 level for the Adani Port.
Imtiyaz, just stay on with us. Just wanted to highlight some other names as well. We have spoken about some of the names. So Madison Sumi was up 8%. Madison Sumi was up 8.5%. Voltas, of course, came in among the top gainers list. Tata Metallics was up a full 20%. Tata Sponge Forex was up 12%. Both are Tata Group companies and both probably move in tandem. Tata Metallics up 20, Tata Sponge up about 19-odd%. Imtiyaz, and if you want Tata Metallics, I mean, it's not a FNO name, of course, but it's done very, very well off late.
Yes, Pankaj, looking at the chart, I think so the stock has shown a very good momentum. You can say at least the stock has given a very fantastic, returns in terms of, the appreciation what we have seen. A few weeks back, the stock on 84-90 level, and right now it has gone to 140 level. This is a very promising, and today it has shown a very good momentum that is showing the 20% higher side with a huge volume. So I think so this is a very positive sign, and the around the level, I think so it is, we technically call it as a rounding bottom. bottom and a cup formation. So this momentum will definitely continue. I suppose the level would, one should be watching was 160, 170 level, which can be achievable in next couple of trading session.
Right. How would you look at HDFC? 10% higher after the results in the month of May. It's already up 13%.
Talking about HDFC Limited?
Yeah, 1215.
Yes, Pankaj, I think so. Yesterday we had seen the momentum just because the market which has been rallied was majorly contribution was coming from ITC and HDFC. So HDFC being a heavy high beta stocks has shown a very good performance. No doubt that can go much higher from this level also, but some pressures are coming on the market, and since it is a high beta stocks, one should be very much careful. If at all everything remains very much silently, I think so 1190 is a very good support. Until the stocks doesn't go below 1190, the stock has the potential to retest 1300 or maybe surpassing 1300 level. So this will be very fast momentum. Maybe in a couple of trading session we can see the stocks going back to 1300 level, and if at all stop support gets break, 1190 got break, then one can see the stocks at you can say some downside, maybe around 1130, 1120.
So Imtiaz, you know, we keep getting this 30-40 bounce up and down, you know, for Nifty every day. So the idea would be that if it goes closer to 1200 odd, buy with a stop loss of 1190.
I suppose even at the current level also one can initiate the buy position with a stop loss of, as I said, 1190. So once that remain very intact, then I think so on a higher side we can see 1300 getting surpassed.
Right. How would you look at Axis Bank? 504 rupees now, again a significant outperformance versus some of the other private sector names.
Pankaj, what we have seen lately in last couple from yesterday till today, the bank Nifty has majorly moved because of the participation coming from the private sector's bank. So yeah, Axis Bank was the one of the contributor which has given a very good contribution for the bank Nifty from the level of 16,400 to today 16,900. So I think so this momentum will definitely continue, and the what I'm looking after for the Axis Bank would be around 470 level as a very good support. So maybe some decline comes somewhere around 480,
490. So here one should not be in an immediate
no,
hurry.
No, one should be not in a hurry at this level. Wait for the stocks to retrace somewhere around 480, 490 level, because over there the risk reward ratio become very much favorable. No doubt the upside is remaining intact, and one can see around 600 level for the Axis Bank in maybe 1 to 2 week of time frame.
Right, but you know, how should one look at it? I mean, you know, a 3-4% decline or closer towards 470, you should look to buy with a 470 stop loss. As you were saying, that the direction should be positive.
Pankaj, what I will do definitely at this level, that I'll wait for the stocks to retrace somewhere between the range of 485-490 level. If the stocks come that level, Axis Bank come in 485-490 level, then definitely I'll start accumulating the stocks with a stop loss of 470 and would see some target of around 560 or maybe 560 plus.
Right. How would you look at ICICI now versus Axis versus ICICI? If you would do, you would probably see there is a very big outperformance of Axis Bank.
Yes, no doubt Axis Bank showing a very good performance, and that would definitely remain intact. But if at all some shifting happened, then I think so the ICICI Bank would definitely show some good momentum. Today the stock was totally in the range of yesterday's trading session, so one should definitely wait for the ICICI Bank. Once the ICICI Bank move around 230 level, then that could be a very good momentum to see, because until unless the higher side resistance break, there could be the round of short covering coming in, and no doubt the stocks can go up to 240 to 50 level.
So you would buy now or you would want to wait?
No, Pankaj, I will definitely wait at the current level and would see somewhere around 230 getting called off, then only I'll initiate a long position.
Right. How would you look at the pharma pack, Aurobindo Pharma? 775 results are yet to be declared.
Yes, Pankaj, today the stock has shown some sort of a weakness, and the weakness would definitely continue. I would definitely avoid Aurobindo Pharma at a current level because the trends is looking very much weakness. Maybe the downside can be projected that stocks can go below 700 level.
Right, but you would want to short for that as a 10% or no?
I would see 760 getting break. If 760 break, then I can initiate a short position.
Similar view for Dr. Reddy's Sun Pharma as well. Lupin declares numbers this week.
I would not closely track Lupin because that would be a very highly volatile stock. But for the Dr. Reddy's, I would wait. I would not go short on the stock, because already we have seen much pain for the Dr. Reddy's from the around 11-12 trading session. We have seen the stocks almost falling from the level of 44,400 till 2,800. So I will definitely avoid Dr. Reddy's for going short.
Right. How would you look at Zee Entertainment? We spoke about Sun TV and how it is moving. Zee Entertainment at 445 after results, it's become absolutely quiet.
Yes, after result, the stocks today has shown a very much silent mode, and I think so this would definitely continue because...
No, it's happening for a while now. You know, every quarter during the results, it moves up, makes a new range and then consolidates in that.
Yes, Pankaj, perfectly analyzed because 440 was the range where the stock was consolidating between the 440 and 360 level. But this time the stock has given a close above 440 level. So I think so there would be some cool off near around 440, 439 level. And from that level, you can see against the stocks going on a higher side. So one should look after for accumulating Zee Entertainment around 440 level.
Right. Imtiyaz, thank you so much for taking out time for us. Always a pleasure.